everyone. I'm just going to quickly show you how I make my own transfer paper. So this is one I made about probably 7 years ago actually, and it still works fine. And when it does start to run out, I just put graphite back over the top and it's good to go again. So I'll just show you how I do this. We'll run through some options. First of all, you need your tracing pad. Just a sheet of, I like to use fairly good quality tracing paper, just because it's a bit thicker. So we'll get our tracing paper. Now you've got a few options with the graphite. It comes in a powder form, or you can use these fatter sticks, or you can even use a graphite pencil. But to make it a quicker process, I would use either the sticks or the powder. So what we're doing is we want to get a nice thick coat of graphite down. We'll try that. I think I'm going to stick with this one, but I'll show you all of them. See, the pencil's going to take a lot longer, and that's an 8B, so you want to use a fairly dark one if you're going with a pencil. And then the powder, put that on. I'll just get a paper towel. Yeah, see, that doesn't really want to stick very well. I wouldn't advise the powder. Go back to doing these. So, I'm just going to stick with this big fat one. These are a bit hard to probably come across. I would have got this from the local art shop. Okay, but it's pretty handy. I don't really use it for anything else. But in saying that, I really only probably need to do this maybe once a year, if that. Happy with that covering. Okay, so next thing, I'm going to use mineral terps, but you could use a rubbing alcohol like isocol, or I've even heard people use lighter fluid. Okay, so we'll just open that up. Cotton wool. Just like that. You don't need much, just a little bit. Just rub it in. And this sort of, this binds it into the transfer paper somehow. I'm not really sure how that works, but it does. Thank you. only going really lightly now. Back on that. Now I'll just let that dry. Just give it a few minutes to dry. And then the next step is I'll go around the edge with some masking tape. And you could probably use a hairdryer to dry that a bit quicker. Just blow on it. The reason I put the masking tape around, you can see on this one, just so that you've got an edge to pick up. It's very handy to have your own graphite paper because it lasts a lot longer than any of the commercial ones you buy. Just the commercial transfer paper. It's easy to make. And yeah, it just seems to just last really well. You also find, because it's just graphite, you can rub the lines out easier, whereas I think a lot of the commercial ones are a carbon, so it's quite hard to rub any lines back out. Have it. So there's your brand new carbon paper. It didn't take long at all. Just a little bit comes off on your hands, but not too bad. Okay, we'll give this a go. So we'll put the carbon paper down. You can see which is the top and bottom, but if you're not sure, you could just write top on your masking tape. Right, I might spin this around. Let's have a look how that went.
Yep.
Beautiful. So there you go. And you should be able to, yep, rub out easy. So if you make a mistake, it comes back off really easy. So there you go, guys. There's my tips on how to make your own graphite paper that will last you for years. All you need to do to refill it is just do the same process as it gets used. Just go back over it, bit of terps again. And we're ready to go again. So hope you enjoyed that, and until next time.